everyone, and welcome to my first Photoshop tutorial. My name is Tyler Bradway, and this is Creativid Studios. We normally work in After Effects, but today I want to show you how to animate in Photoshop. One reason you might want to learn this is to make scribble text, which is like scribbly text. For every frame, it looks a little bit different. When you play those frames back, it becomes jittery, and it makes it look like kind of stop motion-like. So let's make a new canvas by clicking Create New. And I already have a preset, I think, right here. So make it 1920 by 1080. Hit Create. And you'll notice mine has this timeline down here. If you don't see that, go to Window, Timeline. Next, we'll go to Layer. I know you can't see these options up here. I'm sorry. But Layer, Video Layers, New Blank Video Layer. We're going to be drawing on this video layer. Before we do any of that, we're going to have to set our frame rate, because we can see it's 29.97 frames per second. So let's come over here, and here we have options. We'll go to Set Timeline Frame Rate, and we'll choose, like, I like 15. Do they have 18? Type 18 in there. So you're gonna wanna do that before you do any animation, or it's gonna cut out the frames that aren't like part of that frame rate. So you'll see that there's this layer. It's kinda like After Effects. There's this layer called layer one, which you'll also see over here on the side panel, and it's blue. If we unlock the background layer, you'll notice it's purple. And that's because it's a static layer. It's not a video layer. There's a difference. Like, you'll see on video layers, you'll see this little movie icon, film icon. On normal static layers, you'll see nothing. So let's go into how to use this video layer. So we set our frame rate. Now let's draw something. Let's draw a ball. Next, we're gonna right arrow key to the right, I guess. And you'll see it disappears. What it did was it moved it over one frame to the right. So we can't actually draw anything until we know where the previous frame was. So we'll enable onion skins. Say that's not how I wanted it. Say I wanted it a little different. I don't know, for whatever reason. Say I wanted two frames before. Just type in two under the onion skin options. It's under this panel again. And you can change the options, but I'll just leave it. And so we drew that first one. You'll notice it's dark. Then this one's lighter. So now we can draw our second one. Move one frame over. I'm just hitting the arrow keys again. Draw our next one. And I'm just going to elongate it as it falls. I should probably have drawn a ground. So say I wanted to draw a ground that I wanted in every frame. So I select this bottom layer, which isn't a video layer, and I click and hold shift and drag horizontally. That made a ground for me. And this can basically be like a guide layer, because, I mean, you can shut it off and stuff. Come back over into the brush tool, move a frame over, squash it down. So we can be done with it. You get the basic idea. So this is what we got. And if we don't want to see the onion skins when we play it back, unfortunately you have to always come over here and click this. I guess you can do Shift Command S. We'll shut off onion skins. And you can see the animation we have. Let's look at how to make a drawing over video, like an animation over video. So we'll shut off these two layers, and we'll come over into Layer, Video Layers, New Video Layer from File, select your video, hit Open, and voila. So I probably should have mentioned this before, but your video layer should be the size of your canvas. So we were doing a 1920 by 1080 canvas, so our video layer was obviously 1920 by 1080. if you had shot a larger or smaller video, you want to adjust the canvas to that size before you import it. Let's make another video layer on top of this, because we don't want to draw directly on our video. New blank video layer, and do whatever we want. It's the same concept. I don't know what I'm doing. Okay, I guess he got shot by a squiggle. So we got this squiggle and it's interacting with the background. Next, we will look at how to make scribble text. So we'll just shut these off and make a new text layer. Command T to bring up your, just T to bring up text. Click and it will make a text layer, and you'll see it down here. We'll type something animation. Let's make it less letters, animate. Now we do command T to scale it, put it in the middle, hit enter. And this is gonna serve as our template for when we draw our scribble text. So we don't want it to be moving around too much, like between frames, because then eventually it might kind of like stray to one side or something. So that's why we're using this as a template, so we can trace it and use it, make sure it stays in the same spot basically. So we'll do layer video layers, new blank video layer again, and we will draw our letters. So I just changed my color and I'm just gonna demonstrate. So you wanna, maybe I should just demonstrate with this A. So you make the A, then you go to the next frame, and you don't even need the onion skins on because we're just tracing. And you're gonna want like 3 or 4 copies of the A, or maybe 5 because I just drew another one. And then you're gonna just play it back. And if we shut this layer off, we can see this is what it looks like. It's like kind of wiggly over here, but we can adjust that later on. If we aren't satisfied with any of this, we can go back, erase, and edit each frame individually. Yeah, so that's the basics of this. Give this a thumbs up if you liked it. Leave a comment for ideas for the next tutorial, and I'll see you guys later.